And this week, wherever there was a camera pointed in Washington, you could find a member of Congress pointing fingers at their political opponent. A media field day and a national embarrassment as we see this government partially shut down. It's Washington's blame game.
We have to stop playing these foolish games that keep coming to us from the other side of the Capitol.
Well, this isn't some damn game. The American people don't want their government shut down, and neither do I.
Well, the game, the story, call it what you will, has consumed cable news channels and network newscasts. It's dominated headlines, but how does the public separate information from spin from the politicians and the journalists who quote them? How are they supposed to hold their subjects accountable? So to discuss that and more, I'm joined from New York by Errol Lewis, host of Road to City Hall on NY1, New York One, and a CNN commentator here in Washington. Lynn Sweet, Washington bureau chief for the Chicago Sun-Times, and Dan Frumkin of the Center for Accountability Journalism. Lynn, let me turn to you to start with. You're covering this thing. You've got all this game going on, but it's politics, personality, policy, the government partly shut down, the debt ceiling on the horizon. How do you figure out, of all these sources out there, who's credible and who's just a windbag?
Well, I think part of what I try to do is tell you what's happening to cut through it. My focus isn't on necessarily just a quote either from the extreme left, extreme right, or anything that is extraneous, unless the proviso is it's from somebody from Illinois, in which case I will give special attention
that's
to it.
Where Chicago is.
Well, right. I mean, and that is my, you know, my mission is hybrid. I do care about a very much local delegation, but our players, for the moment, aren't the leaders on this. So I think it's almost a day-to-day call, Frank, where you just look at, it's like at a restaurant. You have a whole big menu, but you got to make a decision day-to-day.
Lynn, a lot of criticism about how caught up the media have been, news coverage, in the horse race of all of this, in the politics, and sometimes the more outspoken, the more coverage you get. Here's a quote from Representative Steve King of Iowa, reported in the Huffington Post, talking about the partial shutdown. It's a temporary inconvenience for a lot of people, he said, but if Obamacare is ever implemented, we will never recover from that as a nation. We can never be a free people again. The Boston Globe reported John Culberson, a representative from Texas, a Republican. He referred to this as the most unpopular piece of legislation ever passed. And it's not just the Republicans. Take a listen to what Senator Tom Harkin said from the Senate floor.
We are at one of the most dangerous points in our history right now. Every bit as dangerous as the breakup of the Union before the Civil War.
Lynn, every bit as dangerous as the breakup of the Union before the Civil War. That was quoted or referenced in Reuters, Fox, CBS, National Journal, The Hill, The Atlantic. Should it have been?
Sure, because those stories focused on what was happening in the Senate.
But did Tom Harkin, was he correct when he said this is the most serious moment since the breakup of the Union before the Civil War?
Well, it depends what those stories did in the context they have, which I know, which is Dan's specialty here. But my point is, Frank, when you depend, a lot of this does depend on what your story of the day is and what your focus is. And I have no criticism with my colleagues who are covering what is being said in the chambers. I'm reporting it, especially on the comments that seem a little bit outside common sense.
Errol Lewis, over to you. Words count, and this is just one example. Here's another one tied to all of this, of course, whether Obamacare, the Affordable Care Act, stays or goes or is trimmed or delayed or what have you. The media have chosen to take a number of takes on this one as to how those words are used. But investigative reporter Jimmy Kimmel sent his comedy team out onto the street. And look what they found when they were talking about Affordable Care Act versus Obamacare.
What do you agree with, Obamacare or the Affordable Care Act?
I'm more sort of towards the Affordable Care Act.
So the Affordable Care Act is more affordable than Obamacare?
Just the name says it all.
Right. Do you know that Obamacare and the Affordable Care Act are the same thing?
No, they're not. Thanks, you made me look stupid.
That's what we do.
Okay, you did good.
Errol, the words we choose matter. How do we decide? How are the media doing?
Absolutely brilliant. Look, the reality is, and I mean, of course, you know, the what makes that joke funny is that there are people, because it is tied to Obama, when you call it Obamacare, they have one perception of it that is purely political in its genesis. I mean, that's really all they're really saying. So look, the politics of it does matter. And to go back to, you know, the Harkin comment for a minute, you know, he could be right about that. I mean, if playing with the national debt becomes a normal tool of legislative business, which is, you know, what he's suggesting in a slightly hyperbolic way, that is big. That's big news, not just because it doesn't happen all that often, but because it says something fundamental, and those who cover the market say that it might be a step from which we cannot return.
But, Errol, the question is, on this hyperbole, what the media report, what the public hears, what really is dangerous and present, and what is so over the top that it's just adding to the noise and the heat without clarifying anything?
Yeah, no, absolutely. No question about it, Frank. I mean, you've got to use your best judgment. This is a time for all of us to really be on our game. You know, for example, there are a number of legislators who are opposed to all of this stuff and who are in favor of the shutdown who are calling the Affordable Care Act a bill. Well, you don't let that go unchallenged. You either don't report it or you point out that it's a law. There are those who are going around routinely calling it unconstitutional. I've seen that a number of times. Very disconcerting, because that cannot and should not be. It's really malpractice to let it go unrebutted. You know, you have to say right behind it and maybe challenge them right on the spot and say, this went all the way to the Supreme Court. It is a law. It is constitutional. So, you know, if unless you're going to also go around reporting things without comment, you know, if somebody says the American flag is, you know, pink and purple, you've got to just stop people right there and maybe even take an additional step and say, Congressman so-and-so is routinely going around saying things that are not true or that are very wide of the mark. And
let me bring Dan Frumkin in here. You wrote a really tough piece that appeared on Al Jazeera, as a matter of fact. Yeah. And the headline, Shutdown Coverage Fails America. Coverage fails America. Here's what you wrote. The political media's aversion to doing anything that might be seen as taking sides, combined with its obsession with process, led them to actively obscure the truth in their coverage of the congressional votes. If you didn't already know what this was all about, reading the news would not help you understand. Explain.
This is a really serious thing that's happening. I mean, I know I live in Washington, so it affects all of us a little bit more than the average American, but shutting down the government is about as serious a problem as Congress can have. And so it's really imperative upon the press to tell the public how we got here, not just what's happening every day.
And you don't think the press have been doing that? Mm-hmm. This parade of stories day in and day out?
The coverage has been incredibly focused on both the process, what just happened right now, and also on prognostication. There's been very little of reminding people of the very basic, which is this is a manufactured crisis. Every story should almost lead with the fact that this is day X of a manufactured crisis, of an unprecedentedly extreme act by a party that is trying to subvert democratic
legislation. Lynn, you write those stories every day. What's your response to that?
Well, first of all, I think Dan, in his crusade for accountability journalism and making the call, is important, because I think reporters should make the call. And in this case, how this shutdown happened was because Republicans wanted to inject derailing Obamacare as the price for keeping government funding flowing. So, Dan, I agree with you with that. I don't think it has to be in the lead of every story on it, but I think, this is an art. You have to mix it all in, Frank, in every story to give the context. Again, I maybe not in the lead on it, but you do have to, in this story, especially in print, explain why you're here, but I think you do need to push ahead.
Part of the problem in pushing ahead, and part of the things that confuses the country, is there's so much politics and so much noise separate from the policy itself and what's really happening. I just want to suggest one thing. Errol, you raised the question about, you know, some of the information here. If people want to know, for example, what Obamacare means to them, you know the best place to go? WebMD. Check out the map. You can click on any state. They'll tell you exactly what's happening in your state. You want the politics? Lynn, you're doing it, and the reporters here in Washington doing it every day.
But it's both. I think it's not as if, though, any outlet has just one story devoted to this, Frank. At the Sun-Times, we have multiple stories just about how this health care law is rolling out. Most outlets do. And this is a week where it's a big consumer service just to let people know what's happening.
Errol, last word to you in 10 seconds, if you can do it. If you're keeping a scorecard on media coverage going forward, what are you looking for?
I want to look for the outright fabricated, clearly talking points, false statements to at least be called out. You can report them, but you got to call them out. And then also, you know, you've got to, as Lynn says, you've got to cover every side of it. Here in New York, we show the close sign in front of the Statue of Liberty. Picture speaks 1,000 words.
All right, Errol Lewis, thanks very much. And to others, thanks very much for coming in. Really appreciate it.